They bought a used couch for $27 at Value Village for the new house they just moved into a few weeks ago. KXLY4's Tania Dall joins us live at Value Village. I'm Boone, and Tania, the couple got quite the housewarming gift.
They did. Value Village says that couch came here along the love seat as a private donation. You expect to find some loose change, maybe a TV remote control on a couch, but one family says they found a meowing cat.
Well, then Value Village are like, a live cat? You found a live cat?
Vicki Mendenhall and her boyfriend Chris bought this couch almost 2 weeks ago.
Just a little meow. Meow.
The very next day, something just didn't sound right in their new home.
Every time we would look, we wouldn't hear the meow. And then we'd stop looking and go on with doing what we're doing. We'd hear the meow.
For days, the couple searched for the source of the meowing. In vents, under their porch, and even the basement.
I crawled underneath here, got underneath the chicken wire, and went through to make sure there wasn't anybody in there.
In a house filled with pets, they realized the cat cries weren't coming from one of their own. Late Tuesday night, a breakthrough.
I was sitting here, and all of a sudden I got kicked. I looked down, and there were no other animals around.
Picking up and flipping the couch over, Vicki and Chris made a wild discovery.
So I grabbed the knife and cut the corner out enough to where I could see what was going on, and sure enough, there was eyeballs staring at me.
She was dehydrated and hungry, immediately gave her food and water, and she scarfed that down. And
this little lady was a source of all the meowing. Most likely 4 or 5 years old, she was trapped inside the couch for at least 10 days.
She ended up over here on this side, and that's where we got her.
The cat, now named Vivi, short for Value Village, was already declawed and spayed.
And it's ironic that I work at a shelter and it would happen to me. And a couch that I would buy.
She's being cared for by Spokane, where Vicki works. But there's no microchip to figure out who she belongs to. And the thrift store can't track down who left that couch behind.
Oh, there she meowed.
We actually have an update to this story. After our 5 p.m. newscast, we got a call to our newsroom. There is a family who thinks that that cat and couch is theirs. We've sent a crew to Spokane to hopefully catch that reunion. As for Vicki and Chris, they say Value Village is giving them store credit for a new couch. Reporting live, Tania Dall, KXLY4, HD News.